What is up, guys? Welcome to another video. My name is Sparkman. Yeah, so today we're working with a game guru. Today I want to show you how to create a boss fight, including a health bar for the boss. For this example, I'm going to use the kill quest script. Yeah, so you don't have to use the kill quest script. You'll be able to do it without the kill quest script. Let me show you what this example looks like. You can already see the health bar on top there. That's the boss's health bar. Sort of like Castlevania, it shows you the health bar before it shows you the boss. Maybe in another video I'm going to make one for the player too, so you can see the player's health bar as well. So yeah, so I'm going to take care of these ogres, so the boss is going to mount. We got one more ogre left. There we go. Okay. Okay, so let's get closer, the boss is going to come out. There's the boss. And you can see that his health bar goes down when I shoot. It's obviously tougher than all the other guys. Well, this guy is pretty tough. It would be very hard to beat him with a sword or something. Okay, guys, if you like making your own 3D games, make sure you hit the subscribe button down below. If you're subscribed, be sure to click on the bell next to the subscribe button. It will let you know when new videos come out. Yeah, so we're gonna aim for 50 likes for this video. Okay, guys, hit the like button and let's continue. Now the first thing I want to show you is where the images for the health bars are located. And so we need to go to let's go find the Steam folder, and we need to go to Steam apps. Okay, we're gonna go to Common, Game Guru, we're gonna go to Files, and you can see that I have a folder here called Stuff. Yeah, so here's where I put the graphics for the health bar. So it's basically the same folder where you put the cursor for the kill quest. Here in the middle of the scene I added a trigger zone. Yeah, when you step on this trigger zone, this is when we spawn the boss. Okay, so let me show you how this works. So this is where the triggers. Okay, so I call the boss Minnow. Okay, so here is the boss. Let's go to properties, and you can see that he doesn't spawn at start. Okay, so I also says his health to 1000. All right, that's very important. Let me show you the script. Okay, you don't have to use the script, you can use any of the other scripts. For this example, I'm using the tourist example. So, okay, so this script have an initialization state and a main state. Okay, so the main part keeps running all the time and the initialization state runs only once. So I got some code here, we're going to paste. Okay, we are not going to type it to save time. Yeah, so I will leave this code under the description below so you can just copy and paste it. Okay, so let me just copy this. I'm going to paste it over here. Yeah, you can see that I copied the same code for the cursor for the kill quest. Yeah, so make sure you have these two files for the health bar under this folder. If you don't have that folder, just make a folder and call it that stuff. Now these variables here are to position the health bar. If you don't like the position of the health bar, you can simply change these variables. Let's go to the main part. Let me just make a space here. We are going to paste this here. This is copy. And simply paste it here. Again, you don't have to worry about this. You can leave it like it is, unless you want to modify something. Now one more thing we have to change in this script. And let's just scroll down to all the way to line 174. We have to disable this here. This is for headshots. Yeah, so we have to disable this so you don't kill the boss in one shot. Okay, which would kind of suck. We just close this, save it. Don't forget to save it. Okay, so we're ready to run this. Let's hit the run button. I'm going to try to do this quick. Get rid of all these guys. They're annoying. They're in the way. Keep saying I'm going to make a full game like this. I'm going to call it Sparkman Travels in Time or something. That'll be a lot of fun, you know, if you make a game about time travel and you bring all these cool weapons to the past. Yeah, I think people like that. I don't know. Yeah, let me know what you think down in the comments below. Okay, so here is the boss, and you can see that his health goes down. Okay, I think this gun takes way too much damage. Let me try the... Let's do this the traditional RPG way. With a sword. See if we can defeat this guy. It's his health is like 1000. Let's see if we can fight you with a sword. This sword's too short. I think this sword needs to be bigger. Now, my health regenerates very quickly, okay, but I think if my health was normal, you can see that my health regenerates very quickly. Yeah, to make this interesting, you should probably set the health to not regenerate so quick. Okay, well, screw this, I'm going to use the gun. It's too hard to beat. Start the Uzi. And good night, sleepy. Wah, wah, wah. Okay, so guys, that's how you can create a boss fight and a health bar for your games. Who thinks we should have a game guru contest? I don't know. Yeah, let me know what you think down in the comments below. Okay guys, see you in the next episode. Don't forget to subscribe and like the video. Bye now.